It's my great joy again to be with you. Welcome in our third times of worship. Rad is here and we have Dida. A sister.
Dida.
Thank you so much, Pastor René. And everyone of us here, Ate Evelyn, Chaplain Mark, and Divina. Most of all, our senior pastor, Reverend Dr. Pastor Zaki. I thank you with all my heart for giving us the opportunity. We are, as Jesus said, two or three that gathered together. He always in our midst. Yeah. Let's put it in our heart. Two or three. Tatlo, dalawa na nagkakatigong para sa pangalan ng ating Panginoon, the name of Jesus. When we gather together, two or three, Jesus is always in our midst. With an angels of the Lord. So, I would like to read our verse for today. I would invite you to stand. Let's all stand for our Word of God. From 1 Thessalonians 5:18, it's very short verse. It says, "Give thanks in all circumstances, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you." I will translate it in Tagalog. Kayo'y magpasalamat sa Diyos sa lahat ng panahon dahil ito ay kalooban ng Diyos kayo nga nasa kay Kristo Jesus. Thank you so much. Let me sit down. I start with a story. There's a two friend. And then he said, "Brother, friend, kaibigan, Tagalog, friend, can I borrow your horse?" So they are both Christian, you know, like believers of our Lord Jesus Christ. And then his friend said, "Yeah, you can borrow my horse, but make it sure that you follow the words. Sundan mo yung words because when you let the horse go, you need to say, 'Praise the Lord.'" So the horse will stop. And don't forget, when you want to stop the horse, para huminto ang kabayo, the horse, you need to say, "Thank you, Lord." So he said, riding the horse, and fast, one time, why this horse never stopped? He forgot the keyword, the password. He almost there in the cliff. Almost in the cliff, and he said, "Oh, my brother said, 'Thank you, Lord.'" And that horse stopped here to the cliff. My friends, we're coming for Thanksgiving. Patungo tayo in Thanksgiving. We are looking forward to give thanks. And it is very hard, especially in the early Christians. In Thessalonica, we're Christians. They were persecuted. They were in pain. They were in financial problem. They were like in the middle of the rock. Nasa gitna sila, that being tossed. So, the great apostle Paul wanted to inspire each Christian who been in Thessalonians, the being persecuted, being alone and lonely, that they need to express thanksgiving, even though napakahirap. It's really hard to see thanksgiving, right? When you have sickness, when you have illness, when you have problem in your life. Sometimes we say thank you, Lord, when we have a lot of money in the bank, when after we pay our bills, right? When we have a lot of things that goes our way, it's easy to give thanks. But sometimes it's hard to give thanks when we pass difficulties of life. No, pag dinaanan natin yung mga mahihirap sa buhay nating dinadaanan, it's hard to see give thanks. But here, Apostle Paul says, reminded you and me, pinapaalala niya sa atin, give thanks in all circumstances. Magpasalamat ka sa lahat
ng pangyayari sa buhay mo in all circumstances, either you are in up or in down, you always say, "Thank you, my God." Number one thing to remind that God is good to us. He gave us free life, a breath of life, the neshama. He gave us this life. And it's a reminder that we need to count our blessing. Minsan, hindi natin nabibilang yung ating blessing. We forget to count our blessing. And we focus for ourselves and then we think, "Oh, they were good. I wish I am a billionaire today. You know, I can help more. I wish I am healthy today." But the people also become billionaire. "I wish I'm free today. I cannot go anywhere. They have bodyguards." They were like, they are not so free. Hindi sila masyadong free wherever they go. So there's always be ups and downs in life. But God says through Apostle Paul, just count your blessing. Bilangin mo yung biyaya mo. Count your blessing and name them one by one. So I remember when I was in the seminary, Maranatha Theological Seminary, it was not easy to study theology, to study the Word of God. It's a lot of things pulling you down. So, manahihila ka, nahihirapan ka when you study the Word of God. It just is a conflict. But when you see the message and the love of God in you, you are able to say, "Thank you, Lord." It's because of what Christ done. Dahil sa ginawa ni Jesus. When we come today to worship, it's because Christ did something great for us. He died on the cross. He died on the cross. He gave his life. He came into this world. He is God and become human, dwelt among us, so that you and me, you can experience his grace, his mercy and love. Para maramdaman mo na mahal ka niya, inibig ka niya sa kabila ng mga pinagdaanan mo, kaya mo magpasalamat dahil Christ did something great on that cross so that you can see, "Lord, I come to worship you just to say thank you for saving me on that cross. I am not worthy, but you saved me by your grace." We are saved by grace. That's what the Bible says, that we are saved by grace. And even though we are not perfect, we are imperfect people. Christ, the perfect one, came down. He was born, died on the cross, buried and resurrected, in order you to know that you are most precious than anything in this world. You are precious than gold. You are precious than diamond. Napakahalaga mo. Napakahalaga mo kay Kristo. Mas mahalaga ka pa sa lahat ng bagay na nasa mundo. Kaya one time when we think, "Lord, I'm alone. I'm sad. Why is happening to me?" Count your blessing and name them one by one and see the cross that Christ died for you. And you can see, "Yes, I am victorious. I'm willing to see. Thank you, Lord. I'm willing to see. Maraming salamat, Panginoon. I'm willing to see. Thank you so much, God, because you saved me. You saved me when I am down. You inspired me when I am lost. When I am lost, you guide my way." And as you can say, "Thank you, Lord, because you did something great to me." And that's who we are. We are all sinners, lost in the way. But you will say, "Lord, why me? Why you pick me up? Why you save me?" And that's a reminder here of all Christians. As Apostle Paul says, sometimes we want to give up. Come on, give thanks in all circumstances. Because doing that, you do the will of God. And that's emphasizing that we have Christ in our life. It's not because we are Christian. Christian, it could be a name. But you should feel it. You should feel it in your heart, in your spirit, that you can express and sing to the Lord and say, Lord, I give you my life. I give you all that I have. The music, the song in my lips, the words in my lips is in you because you did something on the cross. It's not all about the Thanksgiving is coming, the giant turkey, gonna catch. Hanap tayo ng turkey para malalaking turkey. There's a lot of sales of turkey in the stores. And then the table is filled. That's a good sense, you know. It's a good fellowship. But when we feel that Christ in our heart, He died, He saved you, you can express thanksgiving. And the Greek word of thanksgiving, it says Eucharistio. The Greek word Eucharistio, it means you're expressing the great joy to God. And if you hear and see this song of Don Moen, thank you, Lord. I just wanna say thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. And King David says, come into his courts. Enter into his court. Pumasok ka sa tahanan ng Diyos na may papasalamat. Dahil ikaw ay minahal ng Diyos. The main reason that Christ come into his court and worship him, count your blessing, because number one thing, he loves you so much. God loves you so much that he died on the cross. So let us pray. Lord, thank you so much that today you reminded us of the word of thanksgiving. Deep in our heart, we see that you did great, something great into our life. That you shed your blood and you died on the cross. Lord, thank you that I'm not worthy, but your grace is enough to save me. Cleanse my heart, my mind, and my soul. Help me to see you, Lord, into my heart today. Search my heart and my soul. Tingnan mo ang aking puso't isipan, Panginoon. Inaalay ko sa iyo ito. Buksan mo ang aking puso upang ako'y maging sa iyo. Lord, I am surrendering my life to you, that I will always expressing, I will always sing and honor you and singing a praising song to you into my heart, because you saved me, you love me, you died on the cross. I will praise you and honor you. Amen.